Procedural clouds in Chaos Corona allow us to add clouds to our skies in just one click. HDRIs are great, but with clouds you can create any type of sky you want, as well as time lapses with minimal effect on render time. So we're going to start at looking at how we can add and customize our clouds, then we'll take a look at animating our sun, and then we'll look at animating our clouds before creating our very own time lapse that will add life to any static scene. To start with, let's add a sun and sky from the Corona menu. Click on the sky and you'll see the clouds tag, and here you can find the cloud parameters. Click enable clouds, and as easy as that, we now have clouds in our sky. The amount will dictate the amount of clouds in the sky. 100% will fill our sky with clouds, and 0 will be no clouds other than the cirrus ones that we can see here. And cirrus clouds are the type of clouds that are high up in the sky. So if we turn this up to 100%, you'll see these small patchy clouds that we generally see high in the sky. So I'm going to put the amount on 65% so we have some clouds in the sky. And variety will randomly change the appearance of our clouds. Phase will make changes to the clouds over time, which can be used to create animations and time lapses, and we'll take a look at this shortly. Seed will randomize the main clouds. The altitude controls where the clouds start, and this is measured from the ground, so just be sure that your cloud's altitude is higher than your skies, else you won't be able to see your clouds. And also be aware you won't be able to set the camera above the clouds and look down upon them because of the way the clouds are created. We also have the height, and turning this up will lead to heavier or thicker clouds, and lowering it will make the clouds lighter and more transparent. The offsets can be used to move the clouds around, and again these are useful for animating our clouds. And just before we take a look at animating them, down here we have contrails. And if we turn up the plane count, we can see more of the contrails in the sky. And we can change the strength to make them more or less visible. And the time will move the planes along their travel path. The distortion will control how much the contrails are distorted, and as with the clouds, we can use the offsets to move the contrails around. So now let's take a look at creating an animated time lapse. So if our clouds are moving, then so is our sun, and we can always animate our sun by rotating it and using keyframes. But if you want a more accurate representation, then we can use the sun tag to dictate the time of day. And now you'll see when we change our hour, we can see the sun moves naturally across the sky. And also be aware that because this is a Corona sky, the position of the sun is going to affect the colors in the sky and also in the clouds, which we can see here. So let's get that animated. Let's set our time to 11 a.m. and make sure that we have the number of frames on 150. And with our time slider on 0, we can control click on the time to set that keyframe. Then let's go to the end of the animation and change our time to 1 and control click again on the time to set the keyframe. So back in our sky, let's go to clouds, and let's start by looking at the offset, which will move the clouds in either the X or the Z. And if we take a look in our top view, we can see the direction of the X here and the Z here. So by changing the offsets, our clouds will move along our Z or our X axis. We can also see our camera is looking somewhere between the two. So if we change both the offset X and Z to 500, notice the clouds will move 500 meters towards our camera as our camera is pointing between the two axes. So let's keyframe the offsets at 0 with control clicking on each frame at 0. And I had a little play and I found that 10,000 meters was a good speed for the clouds to move across the 3 hours. And now we have clouds moving towards us. Phase will make changes to the clouds over time, so let's animate that from 0 at 0 frames to 20% at the end of our animation. And if we want our clouds to change even more, then variety is something else we can animate. So let's change that from 50% to 80% over the course of the day. And one thing we can do before hitting render on our animation is change the keyframes to linear. And if we leave them on default, then the beginning and end will ease in and out, and we don't want that. And now we can unhide the rest of our scene and render the animation. And over here in Chaos Player, you can see we have a really nice time-lapse animation. If you want to find out how to use Chaos Player for compositing, color grading, and editing, then check out this video. Or if you're wondering how we made all the foliage in this scene, then learn how to do just that in this 5-minute video about Chaos Scatter.